bedding on the garage floor. Get a closer look at this thing. So it actually does have a bracket down here, which I imagine could be for an AC compressor. That might happen with this truck later, since it's going to the southern part of the country. But it's cool. We got alternator, power steering pump. I think this is just, that's just a idler pulley. Another idler pulley. Water pump over here. This right here is a cam-driven vacuum pump, I assume, yep. Injection pump down here. Yeah, this is pretty darn cool. Well, I know for one thing, this guy is definitely going to be a clearance issue with the passenger side drop axle on that solid front axle. I've seen other guys with lifts still use these in the Toyotas, but they're just way too close. So I'm either going to move it or with another solution. Time will tell. But it is a pretty compact engine, and tag here states it weighs, well, it says it only weighs 503 pounds, which is gonna be nice. Now let's discuss real quick what actually comes with this engine. Start over here. We got the throttle pedal, the wiring harness plugs into. Got more harness, big cable for grid heater, battery cable, Murphy gauge. So the computer sends all the readable inputs or outputs to this, so you can monitor coolant temperature and whatnot. So it's all electronically done. Got the owner's manual and all that fun stuff. Stickers and these emblems. So they're black and white stickers. And over here, this is the mass airflow sensor. They give you this pre-engineered pipe along with that. They give you some clamps and the sensor and everything. Over here, got the fuel filter assembly. And there's another sensor in here. I can't tell what it is. I ripped this apart because there was a little condensation inside these bags, so that's not good, but these things were capped, so there shouldn't be any issue. Overall, this is pretty sweet. Now it's really just time to get to work. Just started day two. About 45 minutes in, we got the engine, transmission, and transfer case out. Nice to see space finally, although it will be filled pretty soon. Next, I'm just gonna get rid of these hoses and take out everything that is not gonna be an awesome Toyota. Get all that out of the way and then degrease, pressure wash. So here's a before shot. I got my cheap Harbor Freight pressure washer set up to see how this thing does. Got some really gunked on grease down here. I don't know if it's gonna cut through it, but we're gonna try a little bit of purple power on top of that too. See if it works. Alright, did the best I could. It's a lot cleaner under here. Looks pretty good. Make the installation a lot easier working under here, because man, you couldn't touch anything without getting covered in grease. This is all kinked. Now it's all good. I think what I'm gonna do is take the bed off, get that all cleaned up under there, take the spare tire out. There are actually two fuel tanks under the truck. There's a someone added on an auxiliary tank on the driver's side here, which, see the filler. There's the tank. If you can't tell, this video is being shot over the course of a bunch of different days. So, the pile of parts continues to grow. Here, we got the Toyota 5-speed that we're going to use, hopefully, and this transfer case we're going to try to sell. It's a chain-driven unit, which I don't want. We're going to be using the same transfer case that came in the truck originally. It's a gear-to-gear driven transfer case, so they're a lot stronger than these. They don't have as good of a reduction. I think it's like a 2.2 to 1 instead of a 2.5 or so to 1, but you can easily swap out the gears inside here. We're probably not going to do that right away because this is not going to be a strictly off-road use truck. It's going to be mostly on-road with the occasional off-road excursion. So this transmission is a Toyota R150F or something like that. RF150, some number like that. It's basically the same thing as a Jeep AX15. They're made by Aisin, and Aisin basically sold them to Toyota and Jeep, and they're the same transmissions. The only differences are the bell housings, the input shaft, and the output shaft. So there's a company in Ohio called Quick Draw Bell Housings. He's actually making a RF150 transmission adapter to the Cummins engine. So basically, it's the same thing as the AX15 internally, same gears and everything. It's just the inputs and outputs. So that guy, he's actually making those for people to buy to adapt the Cummins to the Toyota 5-speed. These come in the 3-liter, 4Runners and pickup trucks. Should be good. And people have been using the AX15 for the R2.8 now for basically since it came out. That was basically the transmission it was designed to go behind. So, shouldn't have any strength issues. I do not know the story on this whole deal. The truck that it came out of had 200,000 miles on it. I don't know if this one does or not. This transmission, I don't think it has 200,000. Been pulled apart by someone other than the factory, so I don't know if it was rebuilt or maybe quick repair or something, but it has been apart. It goes through all the gears just fine, and the bearings all feel nice and tight. I am going to have a shop go through it regardless, just because I don't know the history, and it would really not be cool to put a junkyard transmission behind a $10,000 engine swap. So the only thing that's different, we're not going to be able to use the Toyota slave cylinder on this side. It actually utilizes a Jeep slave cylinder for the clutch. It's going to go on the driver's side. So I'll have to do some retrofitting for that because I'll end up using the Jeep master cylinder too, I think. Maybe I can switch it somewhere down the line. Going from a Toyota master cylinder to a Jeep slave cylinder, I don't know yet. We'll figure it out. But this transmission should work just fine for what we want to do. Got the shifters for it too. The guy was supposed to give me the drive shafts. He didn't do that, but I got the whole deal here for $150, which is not a bad deal. You got to pay more for a core for these transmissions. Anyway, so I'm still ahead as far as that goes. The next thing for this truck though, I'm taking the bed off. I'm going to strip the exhaust, the tanks, fuel tanks. There are actually two under here. I think I may have showed you that already. But once everything is off the back of the frame and it's all stripped and clean, I'm going to pressure wash the whole truck, bringing it to a place where I actually have access to a steam pressure washer. Those things are awesome for cutting through oil. I'm sure it'll blast the undercoating off of it too. We want to start from scratch with this completely.